Hello students, so we continue our discussion on drug proving. Now we start the discussion of qualities of prover in homeopathy. Now what is the beauty of drug proving in homeopathy? The first time Dr. Hahnemann tells to know the effects of drugs, we should consider the provers as healthy human being for the experiment of drug proving. So very firmly he is taking healthy human beings as the provers for the experiment of drug proving. So first of all, the prover is healthy, and next important, he is a human being and not any lower animals, which is the case in the other systems of medicine. So prover is the only source of information and science relies on him totally. That is the vital role prover plays. So prover is the only source of information and science will totally depend on him. Prover should possess certain qualities as his symptoms are going to furnish our homeopathic materia medica. True homeopathic materia medica must be collection of most accurate symptoms. And later, these will be correlated with the symptoms of patient for matching. Treatment of diseases is done on homeopathic principles afterwards. So the journey continues, journey of physician to accomplish his mission to cure the patient. So the journey continues as we want to acquire the knowledge of instruments. Instruments means the medicines. Okay, so those we are using to cure the patient. So the journey continues. The first step is the formation of materia medica. And in formation of materia medica, there should be collection of most accurate symptoms observed in provers, which are nothing but due to the action of medicines. Thus, these symptoms which are in the homeopathic materia medica are considered for matching with the symptoms seen in patient during the when they are affected with natural diseases. So treatment of diseases is done on homeopathic principles, of course. So to get thorough pathogenetic property of the drug, the qualities of prover should be healthy, delicate prover, a sensitive and irritable prover, trustworthy, intelligent prover who will be lover of truth. And he will be a good observer and very honest, faithful and obedient, so that he will just come with the pure symptoms when he is undergoing the experiment of drug proving. So much is the vital importance of prover in homeopathy. So we go to the next aphorism, that is 121. So aphorism number 121 is, the drug proving in homeopathy is done with the minute dose of that particular medicine which is administered for drug proving. And the aphorism describes further the qualities of prover. So, the even small dose of heroic substance produces changes in the health of robust person. And whereas if the substance, the drug substance is of having milder power, then it is necessary to be given in quantities. The subject of experiment is nothing but our prover, who is a healthy human being. He should be free from diseases. So he is a healthy prover. Healthy prover which gives pure pathogenetic properties of medicine. What will happen if the prover is sick? The sick prover does not give the true picture of medicinal action. Prover must be free from mental and physical morbidity. Prover must be free from mental and physical morbidity. He should be healthy, delicate, irritable and sensitive. And in homeopathy, we need the subjective feeling, that is the symptoms experienced by the prover. The conscience and morality of prover will give true symptoms. He will remain attentive to the experiment of drug proving and he will be devoting himself to the experiment of drug proving. And the dose used of the medicine during the experiment is always a minute dose. It is never a large dose. It is never a heroic dose. So, the experiment is conducted with the minute doses only, and the basic qualities of prover should be, he should be healthy, delicate, irritable nature and sensitive enough to experience the changes of health. He is going to notice due to the action of medicines. So we need subjective feeling from the prover. So we go to the next aphorism. Aphorism number 122. It is describing that true pure experiments are necessary to get the pure picture of the effects of that particular drug substance on the healthy prover. So Dr. Hahnemann expands the importance of health to future generations. In the previous aphorism, he has told us health is a blessing. So the mankind should have sound, healthy, prosperous state of health. And hence, to maintain that state or to achieve the state, the pure and true effects of medicines must be known, right? And they are the pure effects of the medicines are seen on provers, and they narrate these subjective symptoms and they are noted in homeopathic materia medica. The purity and genuineness can be trusted after their effect seen on provers. Okay, so we have to trust on prover. So two important aspects: the prover should be genuinely interested in the experiment of proving and he should be able to devote his attention to the proving. And next important point is the purity of the drug substance, right? So energy is present in each drug which is inherent and universal. they obey fixed laws of nature. So every drug substance has an energy, has a power inherent in it, and that is universal. It is true that the property of gold will never change. Wherever you go in the universe, the property of iron getting attracted to the magnet will never change. And also the property of silver to glitter, the property of gold to glitter will also never change. Why it never changes? Because it is a universal property and it is inherent in that particular substance. Unknown substances are not used in drug proving. They can be dangerous to the life of patient and they will alter the effects of the medicine. So true pure experiments are necessary, and the experiment is conducted with the effect of only one drug substance is given to the patient, and true and pure effects are noted. Each drug substance produces the action with its symptoms, which are very peculiar to themselves. No drug substance will be producing same action. So the energy is present in each drug substance, and that is a quality which is present in each drug substance, which is inherent and universal in nature. So wherever you go in the anywhere on earth, the property of iron, the property of silver, gold will never change, because these properties are universal and they are inherent. Okay, so the purity and genuineness of the drug substance can be trusted after the effect seen on provers. Now we are going to conduct the experiment of drug proving not on one prover only, but on number of provers, so that the purity can be trusted and tested also. Okay, and we are well aware that the energy is present. Energy means the hidden power present in each drug substance. Okay, and that is inherent. So property of alum sepa will never change wherever you go, whichever place you go on earth. So it will retain its enzymes which are present in it. They will never disappear, and that is the virtue by which the drugs produces effects on the provers. Okay, so we always need true pure experiments so that authentic homeopathic materia medica is complete, and we can note down the effects of the medicines which are pure and genuine. Okay, so all these points are very important to understand the homeopathic method of drug proving. So we go to the next. Aphorism number 123 gives us idea about purity of drugs in simple and unadulterated form. So the drug should be used in an unadulterated form. Unadulterated means in the pure form. Now various kinds of drugs are available. If they are indigenous plants, means they are grown in your native area, you can prepare the drugs in the form of freshly expressed juice mixed with alcohol to prevent the spoiling. The exotic vegetables which are grown in the foreign land, They are in the form of powder or tincture. So, the with alcohol, if they were in the fresh state and mingled with water. So, exotic vegetables, the powder or tincture is prepared with alcohol to prevent its spoiling and fermentation. If they are fresh state and then if they are mingled with water. Salt and gums are dissolved in water just before being taken. The plants which are in dry state, the cutting the herbs into small pieces, pouring boiling water, and then you can swallow when warm. So plants which are in dry state, they are cut into small pieces and the boiling water is poured on them. Okay. The last is all aqueous solutions of herbs without spirit pass into fermentation and decomposition. Hence, when we have to use the herbs, we will add spirit to prevent the fermentation. Okay, so we go to the next one. So, in this aphorism, the instruction is given that the brewer should avoid intake of any other medicinal substance. So, during brewing, every medicinal substance is avoided. So, pure without admixture of any foreign substance, the medicinal substance is given to the brewer. So, without admixture of any foreign substance, so only one pure medicinal substance given to the brewer. To avoid anything else of a medicinal nature, or it will have its own effects and will not get pure picture of medicine given for experiment of proving. So see this again, to avoid anything else of a medicinal nature. So we consider that he is not consuming any other substance which is having certain medicinal properties. Otherwise, what will happen? It will produce its own effects and will not get the pure picture of the effects of medicine given during the experiment of drug proving. So, brewer should avoid intake of any other substance having some medicinal value. Okay, so every medicinal substance should be taken in the alone and pure form. It should be taken in alone and pure form. So we get true and pure medicine. We get true and pure medicine. And so that the pure effects of such medicine can be noted down to construct the authentic homeopathic materia medica, which is the basis of homeopathic treatment, and this is the basis of the journey of physician to achieve mission, that is to cure the patient. So all these are stepping stones right from the genuinity, purity of the drug substance and the effects of these drug substance on the brewer, and the various important aspects that about the brewers which are described in further aphorisms with respect to the diet of brewer and what should be his daily life, what he should avoid, and during the experiment of drug proving. So here we are giving importance to the nature of true and pure medicine necessary for the action and conduction of the experiment of drug proving, so that the pure effects are noted by the prover. Okay, and that's all for the today's discussion. Okay, so all of you go through this discussion again and again, and we end this discussion today. Okay, thank you.